jQuery is JavaScript library. jQuery is JavaScript library. And one more point, we can say that jQuery is a tiny version of JavaScript. And one more point, we can say that jQuery is open source. And jQuery is lightweight. So instead of writing lengthy code in JavaScript, we are going to be using jQuery. Instead of using lengthy code in JavaScript, we are using jQuery. So how to use jQuery? The thing is, we are going to be working with a jQuery.com. The major important thing is jQuery.com. Let's move to the jQuery.com. Yes, this is the official website for the jQuery. So where you can find a lot of things like download, API documents, blog, plugins, browser support, and multiple things. What we can do is, you can check with the documentation, go to the download option. You can find out a lot of CDN plugins, or you can download the latest plugin, all these things. And API documentation, you'll be having a lot of API documentation. So latest version of API documentation, you can find out in the part of the API documentation. And the better thing, you can go for the jQuery, go with the download option. And there are multiple things you can find out. So there are two ways of jQuery download. jQuery download. jQuery use process or usage process. So there are multiple things to use the jQuery. One is the download and use. And one is the CDN link. CDN links. So I will tell you what about CDN links are. So whenever you are trying to download and use, you just go with the jQuery production version. There are two type of versions in the jQuery. Anyway, you are going with the download or CDN. There are two type of versions. So one is the production version. One is the development version. So production version is basically compressed one. And smaller in size. And come to the development version. Development version is basically a larger file in size. Uncompressed version. So that's what jQuery basically. Even we are downloading the jQuery or we are using the CDN links, both are two type of versions. One is the production version, one is the development version. So how the production version, how the development version we want to see. For example, let me go with the download compressed version. You can see the compressed version. We can't able to find out the content on. We can't able to find out the code, all those things. And this is not having the spaces and new lines. And this is the compressed version. What I want to do is I will save the content in taking new file and save it. And let me save this into the 11 PM new folder 9x12. And jQuery_min.js. Well, because this is a compressed version, that is the why reason I'm giving to the name jQuery_min.js. So compressed version, you can't able to find out the new lines and spaces, all these things. This is the minified version, and we can't able to understand the code. And let me go to the development version. Let me go to the development version. Uncompressed version. Uncompressed download version. When we go uncompressed download version, that should be completely different. Uncompressed download version. So this is, you can have a lot of spaces and new lines available over there, and copy this content and make it paste into the new file, save it as, and jQuery.js. This is uncompressed version, which is going to be having a lot of spaces and new lines. Let me paste the content. Can we see this? So what is the major difference between the uncompressed version and compressed version? Compressed version, which is going to be not understanding the file, which is not going to be having new lines and spaces, all these things. But uncompressed version, you will be having a lot of spaces and new lines, which is going to be available. Both will be used. Both will be used. Let me save the notes also. Desktop. And this will be in the 11 p.m. 9 by 12. Sorry. And notes. Let me save this was notes. And first we are going with the download version. Then we are going with the CDN links. So once we try with the downloaded one, let me create a new file, save it as demo.html. Okay, let me try to work out the script. Script src. So that will be something like jQuery underscore min.js. jQuery underscore min.js. First of all, I'm accessing the library. After accessing the library, I'm trying to using this jQuery now. And let me try to create some HTML content. Let me create a H1. Hello, web development. And now I'm trying to writing my own custom script. Script open, script close. I want to access the H1. How to access the H1? If you want to access the H1, $H1.html is going to be inner HTML changing. HTML. So Srinivas. I'm trying to giving the name of Srinivas. So this is the basically code, which is same thing like JavaScript. In JavaScript, the same code which is going to be available. Document.get elements by tag name. Name of the tag is going to be H1 of zero. And which is going to be having something like inner HTML. And which is going to be having something like Srinivas. The same code we are trying to writing with the jQuery with the similar code, but shorthand method. So what is the shorthand method in the jQuery? jQuery shorthand method is very simple, straightforward. $H1.html Srinivas. That's it. So $H1 is going to be accessing your element. In JavaScript, that is going to be same like document.get elements by tag name H1 of zero. Instead of doing that, $H1 is enough. Instead of inner HTML, here HTML method is enough. And finally, output will be very, very similar. So output will be Srinivas. Instead of writing JavaScript, we are writing the jQuery. Instead of writing JavaScript, we are writing jQuery. That's it. So this is the tiny version of JavaScript. So anyway, JavaScript will work, but I'm not working with the JavaScript. I'm working with the jQuery. jQuery dollar is very important symbol. What is the dollar here? Dollar is nothing but jQuery. So you can write instead of dollar, you can write jQuery also. jQuery of h1.html is Srinivas. So finally, output will be Srinivas. That's all. So this is the way of using the minified version. At the same time, I'm trying to using the normal version, development version, which is not having spaces and new lines, but bigger in the size. Minified version is the lesser in the space. Okay, let me try to use the normal version, jQuery.js. I'm not using the manifold version, jQuery.js. When I'm trying to using the jQuery.js, the same output you can able to see. Srinivas, content got updated. So this is the download and use. And there is the one more process of using jQuery, that is the CDN version. How to use the CDN version? Let me show. Taking new, and this will be the demo_cdn_.html. So this is the CDN file I'm trying to using. When I'm trying to using the CDN, this normal downloaded one I don't want. So what I want to do is go to the jQuery.com, go to back, come down, you will find out some CDN links. So there are multiple CDN providers which are going to be available. CDNs are 24/7 running servers, clouds. From the clouds, I'm taking Google CDN. So let me take the Google CDN. Google CDN is providing the jQuery file, script file. So let me take the script file, attach in your program. So this is CDN file. This is not a downloaded one. And for CDN files, always internet connection is required. Internet connection is always needed. For this download and use, no need to connect with internet. For this download and use. For CDN, you have to use the internet connection. If you don't have the internet connection, you can't able to do work with the CDN content. Why? Because of this is loading from HTTPS, Ajax, Google APIs, .com, Ajax Lips, jQuery 3.6.0, jQuery min.js. This is loading from the cloud. Okay, so output is same. There is no change with output. Yes, I got Srinivas. So that is a way of using the download file, and that is a way of using work with the CDN file. Both are look like same. Now, what is the method called .html method? What is the method called .html? .html is going to be working with changing inner HTML of element. That is called .html method. Okay, so we are accessing elements now in the same way. How to access classes. Next, save it as access classes. How to access classes? Processor is same. So just want to copy the CDN link, whatever the CDN link we have. I'm trying to copy in the CDN link. After that, I'm trying to work with the H1. So full stack web development. For this H1, I want to take a class. Let me take a class for the H1. Class is equal to one. So if I'm having the class, not element. If it is element, just $H1 or $div. But this time we are going to be trying to accessing the class. If you're trying to accessing the class, $.classname. What is the class name called? one.html. I want to change the HTML of that. So same like Srinivas. Finally, what is output of this? Output of the content is basically Srinivas, but inside the HTML, we are going to be giving full stack web development. Full stack web development got converted into the Srinivas. Why? Because of your jQuery is working. Instead of writing document.getElementsByClassName, name of the class at the same time. How to access IDs? Access ID dot HTML. If it is ID, if I don't have the class, I'm trying to access it with ID. If it is ID, not class. If it is ID called one. If I'm having the ID, what I require is with instead of the dot, I need to specify the hash. Why? Because jQuery look like CSS. In CSS, what number of selectors we are going to be available? All the selectors are coming into the jQuery also. In CSS, if you want to access ID, hash symbol is required. But in the part of the jQuery, we need to take a hash symbol again, and the name of the ID is one.html. So you find the output one.html got Srinivas. That's it. So we're done with the access elements. We're done with the access IDs. How to access elements? How to in jQuery? How to access elements in jQuery? Let me try to write something. Syntax I'm writing. $ and element name. $ element name. Dot. Whatever you want. You can do something like dot HTML. Whatever you want. Okay. HTML text will be here. Same time, I want to access the classes. How to access classes? Concept is same. Access classes in jQuery. Instead of elements, I want to work with the classes. How to access classes in jQuery? Instead of this element name, I need to give the dot class name. Dot class name. Concept is same. HTML text will be changing. All these things are going to be happening. In the same way, I want to access ID. How to access ID? Let me write the syntax for accessing ID. Access ID in jQuery. Access ID in jQuery is very simple. So instead of dot, what I want to do. So for classes, we need to give the dot. For ID, we need to give the ID name. ID name. HTML text will be here. That's it. This is the way of accessing elements. This is the way of accessing classes. This is the way of accessing IDs in jQuery. At the same time, if I want to change CSS in jQuery, change CSS in jQuery. The one more DOM operation we are trying to work out. How to change CSS? So whatever the element name you are going to be accessing, h1 dot method called CSS. Method called CSS. For suppose I want to change the color. Color colon. And so this is not going to be colon. This will be red. So let me try with this. I want to change the h1 CSS. Color I want to change. Copy this, paste new, save it as, and change CSS. Change underscore CSS dot HTML. What I want to do this time, I want to take Srinivas. But for Srinivas, I want to go with one more thing, dot CSS. There is a method called CSS. And there is option called color. And there is option called red. If I want to change one property, single property, you can directly write a method called CSS method. Now, you got a color red, obviously. We got a color red, obviously. Why? Because of your changing the color. But in JavaScript, the same code we need to write. Document.get elements by tag name. Name of the tag we need to mention. H1 of 0. Then we need to give the dot style dot color is equal to something like red. Instead of using the lengthy line of the code, I'm trying to using the short line of the code. Dollar hash1.css, color red. One color, one property got updated with this particular element. Now, change the CSS with multiple properties I want to go with. Change CSS with multiple dot HTML. If I want to change multiple CSS properties, what I want to do with? So Control A, Control C, and Control A, Control V. Now, what the final thing is, I want to access multiple properties in the same time. I don't want to go with the only color. I don't want to go with the only color. I want to do with the multiple properties like font style, all these things. Then what we need to trying to doing is, inside the dollar symbol, we need to take object. Instead of dollar symbol, take object. Okay, so dollar, I want to access the element. What is the element we have? hash1.css and try to write object inside. Object nothing but a key value pairs, color colon red. I can choose my color. So with the same property, I want to implement multiple things. Comma this, and this is one object, for example, and comma one more object, key value pairs. So first time I'm giving color red, second time I'm giving text align. Text align, that should be center. And one more is a font face. You want font face or a text decoration? No. Font style. Let me give the font style now. Font style is colon, something like italic. So we are trying to providing multiple objects at the same time inside the CSS function. And that is going to be encloses with the parenthesis. And each and every key value pair separated with the colon. And each and every key value pair separated with the comma. We are having three properties. One is the color, one is the text line, one is the font style. And finally, guys, we try to understand. So we got Srinivas that. Srinivas got center aligned. Srinivas got a red color. And what are the properties which is not going to be applicable? Font style, italic, spelling mistake, italic. Font style, spelling mistake, italic. When I say italic, obviously this will be in the italic mode. Can we see this? So italic mode got applied. In the same way, if you want to try to work with the attributes level, if you want to try with the attributes level, you can go with the attributes level. How to change attributes with jQuery? Attributes_jQuery. So let me change to work with attribute.html. Every time I want to take HTML file. So what my requirement is, I want to add one attribute for the div or h1. So what I want to do for that? Now we are working with attribute level. So dollar h1 or what is this one? Dot. And what do you want to do for this? I want to change the attribute. So what is attribute name? Attribute. If I want to have the single attribute like title, I can give the value something like a Srinivas full stack. Now try with the attribute, open in the default browser. And when I do hover on this Srinivas, I can see the title. So where we got the title? Title attribute not applied. Title, T-I-T-L-E, title, H-E-G-R. Yes, okay, open in the default browser. I can see, I do hover on this particular H1. H1 is not getting updated now. What is the problem with this? That is the problem. Well, because that is ID now. So whenever it is ID, hash one dot attr title Srinivas full stack. So let me save this now and try to execute this one. And we got the title. We got the title Srinivas full stack on when we hover on the H1. When we do hover on H1, we got the title. What is the title we got? Srinivas full stack. Yes, that is working. That is working fine. And the same time, if I want to try to apply multiple attributes at the same time. For example, for H1, I am writing the class. Dot one. That will be the class. So let me write the class called one. Dot one, I want to give the background color. Something like a brown color, and color will be white. At the same time, text line center. So that is my class called one. One is a class I'm trying to add in this. I don't want any class declared for that. And I want to add a title and a class at the same time. Instead of giving only title, I want to add a title and class same time. So hash one dot attr. Then I want to go with the function object. I want to go with the object. What is us? Object is going to be contained with the key and value pairs. The first key and value will be title and Srinivas full stack. Let me take that. And comma, I want to add a class. Here it will be the colon. Why? Because object containing a key value pair. First key is the title, value is Srinivas full stack. And second key value is class, and value will be something like what is the value we have? Something like one. And finally, try to work out all these things. Class is going to be adding. Yes, class added already. And when we do hover on this, you can see the title also. So I hope.